Yes, folks, it's not breaking news, but it's bad news. It's news that can break your spirit, but don't let it, because here we go. With this being said, I said that to say this, that when people hear things like this, they become fearful. It causes fright in them. It gives them the spirit of fear. Now let's listen up carefully.
Not sick. A woman who supposedly felt ill after having a close encounter with an escaped laboratory monkey in Pennsylvania is not sick. Michelle Fallon has said that despite media reports about her health, she is not unwell and had been given rabies shots and antibiotics as a precautionary measure. I want people to know I am not sick regardless of what they are reading that has been put out there in the media, she told the Daily Item. A truck carrying 100 imported macaque monkeys was headed to a Missouri lab when it collided with another vehicle on January 21st on an East Central Pennsylvania highway. Fallon was the first to the scene and had gone to help the driver when one of the escaped monkeys hissed in her face. In a Facebook post which can be found here, Fallon said that the driver of the truck had not advised her to stay clear of the monkeys, which is why she had approached them. I am worried. People think I have a monkey virus, she wrote. News reports that followed said Fallon had fallen ill, leading to conspiracy theories surfacing online. Some people took to the internet suggesting that the crash was staged in order to start another pandemic. Jason Booth tweeted, "Isn't this how the virus in the movie Outbreak started?" Another Twitter user, Randy Brown, said, "Monkey virus? Well, COVID is fading, ports are batting down mandates. Doesn't look like it will hold till the midterms. So, another lab accident. Monkey virus. Zombies. Pink eye. I think there was a movie about this one." According to the CDC, this species of monkey commonly spreads herpes virus B through saliva, feces, or urine. Joe Stender, spokesperson for the Geisinger Medical Center, where Fallon was treated, told the newspaper the hospital is following guidance from the Pennsylvania Department of Health and the CDC. It will treat anyone potentially exposed to the monkeys. In the interview with the Daily Item, Fallon said she had attended a party after the monkey incident where a number of guests later tested positive for COVID. I explained what happened and they said I was at very low risk of anything, but I went to get checked out anyway because I started to not feel well, she told the newspaper, saying COVID could have been the cause of her symptoms. The monkey escape incident is currently being investigated by the U.S. Department of Agriculture following the complaint filed by the People for the Ethical Treatment of Animals, PETA. PETA said that the CDC should be scrambling to ensure that numerous other people who were at the scene are not in danger of catching a disease. The organization has also raised concerns that the monkeys have not received veterinary treatment. Monkeys and other primates may be brought into the United States for scientific, educational, or exhibition purposes. However, PETA said that this happens with no oversight, and monkeys often endure day-long trips sitting in their own urine and feces. PETA said that this incident is another reason why it is calling for the closure of nationally funded primate research.
So I want you to hear the news, but keep moving forward. Hear the news so you can be updated, so you can be alert and aware of what's going on in the airways. But at the same time, pay not attention to your emotions because they tend to go up and down. So you cannot rely on them. When you hear something, it is just for your benefit. Utilize this information to grow, to be knowledgeable. Last but not least, test the spirit to see whether or not, to see if it's from God. They want us to be monkeys so bad. They want us to be created from monkeys so bad, you guys. They want us to be connected to monkeys some type of house so bad. Marana, what I'm supposed to do?
I know you want me to be vigilant, but what exactly does that mean? You mean just continue to say these prayers?
Yeah, literally. I just want you to read your scriptures.
Shh, don't say nothing. Jesus got you. He got you.
I hear you, but now really, I hear you. But what you expect me to do?
Hush, hush, there now, quiet now. You're off the bottle, you're on the meat. Get your sword and your breastplate.
It is a new world, so be brave. Let not your hearts be troubled. For God hath not given you the spirit of fear, but of power, love, and a sound mind. And no weapon forced against you shall prosper.
Beloved America, listen up. Get the monkey off your back. Don't worry about this fear. False evidence appearing real. New world order is in, saints. Remember, the stage has already been set. Now it's 2022.
Genesis chapter 1 verse 26 reads,
then God said, let us make man in our image according to our likeness. Let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, over the birds of the air, and over the cattle, over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creeps on the earth. So God created man in his own image. In the image of God, he created him. Male and female, he created them. Then God blessed them. And God said to them, be fruitful and multiply. Fill the earth and subdue it. Have dominion over the fish of the sea, over the birds of the air, and over every living thing that moves on earth.
Marauder Prophecy signing out. I'm gone for now, but I'll be back. Story officially debunked. God's people should not be worried. God bless.